are you contemplating going out somewhere? The shadow on the wall tells me the sun is going down. Oh, ruby, don't take your love to town. It wasn't me who started that old crazy Asian war, but I was proud to go and do my patriotic chore. Yes, it's true that I'm not the man I used to be, but Ruby, I still need some company. It's hard to love a man whose legs are bent and paralyzed. And I walk up the knees of a woman your age, Ruby, I realize. Cause it won't be long, I've heard them say, until I'm not around. Oh, Ruby, oh, don't take your love town. Come on, Mike. She's leaving now, cause I just heard the slamming of the door. The way I knew, I've heard it slam 100 times before. And if I could move, I'd get my gun and put her in the ground. Oh, Ruby, oh, don't take your love to town. Oh, God's sakes, turn around. Yes. Thank you. Hello, everyone out there in TV land. This is Don Ellis Gatlin. This is the Don Ellis Gatlin Show with my unbelievable special guest, the Kenny Rogers Band. Come on. Our studio audience, come on. Oh, my gosh. I'm going to introduce some far left cameras over there. This man is incredible, Mr. Randy Durham right there, everybody, on guitar. This incredible singer and keyboardist right here, Mr. Gene Sisk, everybody, on keyboards. The man behind the kit, Mr. Mike Zimmerman. And on lead guitar, Mr. Brian Franklin. Now, we do have two incredible members missing tonight because they're in their home state right now visiting folks. Mr. Steve Glassmeyer on the keyboards, incredible songwriter and musician, keyboardist, and Mr. Chuck Jacobs on the bass. We love you guys. Wish you were here, but they are here in spirit. They are here in spirit. I tell you what, also a couple of my SJ bandmates in the house tonight, way over there in the corner, Mr. David Abdo filling in for Chuck just tonight. He's incredible. And, of course, the guy that travels with us in the Kenny Rogers Show with Don Gatlin, this Mr. Tony Hahn on lead guitar. Now, folks, these guys have been all over the world, did all the incredible shows with the great Mr. Kenny Rogers, folks. And I'm so proud to be, just to know these guys. They're so incredible. Savannah Jack got to go out on the road and do, as I mentioned before, 66 shows opening for these guys. I would stand off to the side of the stage, watch soundcheck every night, because they play these incredible songs to perfection. And it's always a dream to get to sing songs. And I'm the biggest Kenny Rogers fan in the world. Always have been, always will be. And I'm going to start over here to my far left. Actually, Randy, I'm going to invite you up here to join me so people can see you better. Randy Dorman again, everybody. Come on. Randy, you could grab that mic right there. Reason I'm starting with Randy, because he's got seniority.
Yeah, I'm old.
Is his mic on? No, you're not old, Randy. You just got seniority because...
I'm old.
You started with Kenny Rogers in...
1977.
Is he on? Yes. Okay. In 1977, everybody. Yep. Come on.
Right.
And that was an incredible time because Kenny Rogers had this incredible career with the first edition.
He did.
All those great hits. Came to Nashville. He started. I mean, he wrote songs for Eddie Arnold and other people like that. Then he got his solo career together. And 1977 was that magical year.
Yeah, yeah.
That's when it just exploded again.
Lucille had just started up to number one on the charts, and that's when I joined. I figured that's probably why it went number one. It's because I joined him, you know.
Makes sense.
I never knew that before. You are the good luck charm.
I am the good luck charm.
I mean,
funny story about the first edition. I was sitting in, I remember it distinctly, when I first heard Just Dropped In, I was in the right seat of the car, and my mother was driving, and that came on the radio, and I thought, that was the coolest song ever. Oh. And I thought, how cool would that be, you know, to have a song like that? And lo and behold, later on, here I am playing that song with the guy that wrote it.
Well,
not wrote it, but performed
had a hit with it.
Yeah, had a hit with it.
And the Big Lebowski, too.
That's right. The big, big,
well,
big.
How about, how did it happen, though? You were playing in a very popular band. I mean, you had your own thing going on.
Well, yeah, I actually got to Nashville via Roy Clark. Roy Clark invited our family to come watch him. Yeah, come watch T-Hall. He had bought a plane that my dad was director of flight school and ground school. And I drove from Florida to meet him in San Angelo. I'm from Texas originally.
Yes.
And
Texas right there.
Yeah, Texas boy. And then from that, he invited us, the family, to come to Nashville and watch him record Hee-Haw. Well, I like Nashville so much, I stayed and got a gig with a group called the Brass Monkey. And a few bands later, here I am with Kenny, you know.
Brass Monkey.
Yeah, the Brass Monkey.
That's a great tribute.
It was
question.
A great, it was a horn band. It was pretty cool. Pretty a lot awesome. Of tower power and stuff
and,
like that.
And so you're thrust into the Kenny Rogers band. Lucille, I mean, this thing, for those country new artists out there or new country fans that might not remember this, Lucille was one of those songs that you would never expect to be. I mean, it's country.
It is very country.
I mean, it's
country.
A country record. And it was a gigantic pop hit.
Yes, it
gigantic
crossed over.
Pop hit.
Crossed
and
over.
It's, but it's country as dirt.
Made him a worldwide worldwide star.
Yes, and that to me was the magic.
Yeah, the I think, beer drinking.
I think there's a little bit, and I think, if I'm not mistaken, Ray Charles was one of Kenny Rogers' biggest influences.
Oh,
as a
yeah,
vocalist.
Absolutely.
And you hear it in his voice.
Well, you know, Ray Charles said, I want to take R&B and make it country, and Kenny said, I want to take country and make it R&B.
That's what I was getting to.
Right.
And I think he did that.
He did,
I think
absolutely.
It's a magic. There's like, he's singing these country songs with that incredible voice. That, you know, Kenny's what I admire so much about his voice is that he can sing pop as good as anybody.
Oh, yeah.
He can sing
absolutely.
The soul as good as anybody, but he can sing that traditional country. I mean, I remember when 10 years ago, mm-hmm. my cousin Dolly and her husband Jeff, we'd go over their house a lot. And that's where I first saw they had the 10 Years of Gold album.
Your cousin's Dolly?
Not Dolly Parton. My cousin Dolly Rao. And
anyway.
She had the they had the 10 Years of Gold album.
Mm-hmm.
And I just remember putting that on, and it blew me away. Because a lot of those songs I had not heard. Keep in mind, in 77, I'm 10 years old or 9 years old. And
boy, that really makes me feel
old. Now, come on, Randy. You look great, man. So I'm listening to this album, and it just blew me. I'm like, every song, his version of Today I Started Loving You Again.
Yep.
That's the version I knew. I knew that before I knew Haggard's version.
Yeah.
That was just incredible. And you were right there when all that, that Lucille album.
Mm-hmm.
What was the name of it? Do you remember the name of that album? Was it called Lucille?
It was called Lucille.
The Lucille album, Platinum. Comes right after that Daytime Friends album, Platinum. 10 Years of Gold, like multiple. That's in
right.
1 year.
Right.
That magical 77 year.
He was known for competing with himself on the charts.
Unbelievable.
Every time he'd release a song, it would be competing with the song previous that, you know, would knock him off the charts.
That's unbelievable. Randy Dorman, everybody.
Thank you.
It's unbelievable. We'll have him back up here, but I just want
to. You tired of talking to
that's
me?
That's it. You're done. That's incredible. We'll have him back up, too. But, folks, fast forward. We're going to be going back and forth. But we had a chance to, as I mentioned, the Savannah Jack get to go out on the road. What happened, what really inspired that whole thing is that I wrote a song and with Mike Uvula and Steve Dean, and I was just very proud of the song. A gentleman named Howard Fields, who was working with the company, with the management. He got it over to Kenny, and he loved it. And the thing was so cool about the album, This Is On, it was the Kenny Rogers 50th anniversary album, Greatest Hits. All the big hits were on it, Lucille, Lady, all the big ones. He added two new songs, and my song was one of them. And it was such an unbelievable honor, and that led to, hey, basically we were in the studio with Tony Brown, who produced those sides, and he said, Kenny said, what are you guys doing? I'm like, what's he mean? What's he mean? And he's like, well, you guys want to go out and play with us? I'm like, and then, you know, it's the ultimate dream come true moment for me. I mean, like, I had every single Kenny Rogers album, just him to know who I am. I remember the first time I was over Brent Mayer's place, and I'm walking into the studio. I was going to walk in the studio to grab my I left something in there, and I saw Kenny through. I did. I saw Kenny through the thing, the studio thing, and I just did a complete one. It turned around, and I was so scared. I went the other way. I ran the other way. I was so scared, but it's what a thrill of a lifetime. The song was called Something's Wrong in Vegas, and we're going to play it for you right now with the Kenny Rogers Band. Yes!
No more phone calls, emails, postcards saying she's doing well out there. Something's wrong in Vegas. I know the truth could break my heart. Something's wrong in Vegas. It's not like her to leave me here in the dark. Is her name up in lights? Is she in someone else's arms? Is she in some kind of trouble? Or is she just moving on? Childhood sweet. Coming queen, she still loves me in my dreams, but I know something's wrong in Vegas. Mr. Tony Hawk. Said she sent me a ticket when she settled in. Don't she realize how long it's been for me? Something's wrong in Vegas. Something's wrong.
The fellas. Woo-hoo-hoo. Hey, I do want to say this before I forget. I'm very proud to say we actually are touring around the world. I get to play shows with these guys. We're celebrating the incredible music and career of the great Mr. Kenny Rogers, starting with the first edition, going all the way through 70s, 80s, 90s, 2000s, all that stuff, all those great songs, all those great moments, and a lot of surprises, including the Kenny Rogers Band Speed Round.
Right.
In fact, if someone out there watching live tonight really, really wants a song,
don't do it.
Don't do it. Shut that down. For a small fee, because there is tonight another Waffle House after party. For a small fee, we will attempt maybe a little speed round. You know, some out there. We got a lot. I'm sure we have a lot of Kenny Rogers fans and Kenny Rogers fans of the band right here.
We don't have Steve here to remind us
of what he is in. I know. Yeah. Steve, wait a minute. We can, if Steve's watching, we can get Steve to just type in what key the thing is. Steve. Throw your guys the keys. Come on. All right. Second longest running member here tonight is this guy to my left, Gene Sisk, right here, folks. Yes. What's that? Oh, yes. I almost did. Mm-hmm. I told you. Don't forget, KennyRogersBand.com will have all the tour dates, all the great photos of me. No. We'll have all kind of great stuff on there, folks. It has all, again, all, we'll be traveling all around the world, and we're very excited. It's a great show. I promise you'll absolutely love it. We'll take you down memory lane in a really awesome way, I promise you. And also, we have a brand new Christmas album. I'm gonna be plugging that the whole show. We're very proud of this thing. It's 10 classics. These guys, they're playing on this record is sick. It's incredible. They get to really stretch. You guys get to stretch on this one. There's some jazz, blues, R&B. It's all there, folks, on these Christmas classics. And one new song. They let me write a new song for the Christmas album. Got one new song. And we're probably going to release as a single here not too long from now. So be looking for that on the website, on Spotify, and all that good stuff. There you go.
There you go.
Back to Gene. Gene.
Yes.
You joined when?
I joined in 96, Christmas show of 96. I had met these guys about four or five years before, previously, because we were the middle act when Kenny was the third act in his In the Round tour. We were the middle act, and the opening act was this guy no one had ever heard of named Garth Brooks. And that's when we met.
Did you say Foster Brooks?
and that's when Garth started, and Eddie Rabbit was the guy that I was playing with.
That's what I was going to say. You worked with another legend.
I worked with Eddie Rabbit for 12 and a half years. I was his music director.
That's a long time.
12 and a half years, yeah.
What is your favorite Eddie Rabbit song?
Suspicions.
Oh, Suspicion. And I'm so glad that I met you, baby. I'm so proud when you walk in a room. That's a great song. I had that album on vinyl. that hits like Gone Too Far on it.
Yeah. Yeah.
And Pour Me Another Tequila, Make It a Killer One More Time.
Make It a Killer.
Great album.
Anyway, that was the band I was with, and I played piano and sang the high harmonies. And when the guy that left Kenny's band, when he left, he played piano and sang the high harmonies. So they remembered me from Eddie's band, and that's how I kind of got the audition. That's right.
Yes.
And the guy I was replacing, his name was Gene.
That helped Kenny.
He didn't have to learn a new name. They didn't have to read.
He might forget the drummer's name, but not yours.
They didn't have to put a Gene's mix, Gene's keys. You know,
yes.
It was all already set for me.
Great for the roadies.
Just right in there.
Well, Gene, you also been in the studio. You've been a studio musician over the years,
right,
too. You actually, if I'm not mistaken, played on that legendary first tracks of the Judds.
That's right.
Am I right or am I right?
Not the first album, but the second album. I was the
first
piano player when the Judds ever played live. And
wow.
That's how I got to be on the second album. And I got to, that's Have Mercy, that's my solo.
But I'm curious, why do you discriminate? You only play with Hall of Famers. I mean, serious, could you just throw a bone to the little guy?
Oh,
is it just Hall of Famers
and
that's
others.
It?
I've played with others as well. Believe me, I've played with others. Believe me.
That's right. Wow. Y'all been beautiful out there. Thank you very much. You're not coming to the Waffle House after party. Randy's out. All right. Going back to 10 Years of Gold, I'm going back again. There's a song on that album, 10 Years of Gold, which I loved. It was also a number one country song. Again, this song crossed over to the pop charts. And again, it was like, we thought 77 was a big year. Randy, that was a big year, but didn't come 78. But here's one from 77, number one song called Daytime Friends. It goes like this. And he tells her he's working late again.
but she knows too well there's something going on. Been neglected, and she needs a friend. So we're trembling fingers down the telephone. And Lord, it hurts her doing this again. He's the best friend that her husband's ever knew. And when she's lonely, he's more than just a friend. He's the one she longs to give her body to. Daytime friends and nighttime lovers, hoping no one else discovers where they go, what they do, in a secret hideaway. Daytime friends and nighttime lovers, they don't want to hurt the other, so they love in the nighttime and shake hands in the light of day. When it's over, there's no peace of mind, just the longing for the way things should have been. And he wonders why some men never find that a woman needs a lover and a friend. Daytime friends and nighttime lovers, hoping no one else discovers where they go, what they do, and the secret hideaway. Daytime friends and nighttime lovers, they don't want to hurt the other, so they love in the nighttime and shake hands in the light of day. Daytime friends.
Thank you. I can't believe you could fit this many hundreds of people in this studio. So glad everyone of you are with us.
It's overwhelming.
It's unbelievable. Well, to my right is this amazing guitar player. This guy is such a great guy, personally. He's a wonderful person, but he's also an amazing guitar player. And his name is Mr. Brian Franklin, everybody. Wait, Brian, hold on. No, I'll help you.
Are you gone?
All right. Brian, when did you join the Kenny Rogers organization?
2001. Yeah.
That year, I'm trying to think what record, that was coming off a big, big record.
It was Buy Me a Rose.
Buy Me a Rose. Yeah,
exactly.
So you got to do all the, like, Tonight Show and all that cool stuff.
I just missed it. And Hawaii and a bunch of cool stuff. But
oh, sorry.
I got a lot in my time here. So.
But Brian, we talked about this before. You, again, play with some really cool country music acts when you were like a baby.
Yeah.
I remember you told me you worked with the Kendalls.
Yeah, I was 17, 3 months out of high school, and opted to forego college and go right into my
Did you have long hair then? Did you ever have long hair?
I had a big mullet.
You had the mullet,
no,
too?
No, not really a you traditional. Didn't? It's kind of like a mullet, yeah.
So that was a good – I mean, that was such a great experience probably to work with a national, you know, touring act like the Kendalls that hits, and just like, because you were just wet behind the ears, just getting
totally. They took me under their wings and kind of eased me into it.
Wow.
Yeah.
Heaven's just a sin away. Whoa, whoa. One of their big hits.
Pittsburgh Steelers.
And they call us the Pittsburgh Steelers.
That's right.
But so after the Kendalls, where'd you was next?
Mark Colley. Mark Colley. Yeah. Sorry, Mark.
Really meant a lot to you, Brian.
Yes. No, that was one of my funnest gigs. It was
Mark
awesome.
Mark Colley is fantastic.
Yes, he was awesome.
He had some really cool tunes.
Yeah.
What's that song about the moon? He had a big song.
Even the Man in the Moon is Crying.
Even the Man in the Moon is Crying. Number one record, I think.
It was. Totally. His first one, I think. Yeah.
So how'd you get the call? When did you get the call that you had a shot to be in Kenny Rogers' band?
Well, Kent Wells was... had worked on and off with these guys and Dolly, and he was offered the job, and he opted to stay home and watch his kid grow up. So he recommended me, and there was like three of us, and we all three auditioned and got to.
Did anything go crazy like your first show? Because Brian, you're amazing, but you are injury prone.
It's true.
This guy has more bumps and bruises than I've ever seen in my entire life. So, like, did you trip and, like, fall down? Like you to me, like, you'd be the country version of the Mark Wahlberg in The Rock Show. You know, in his first gig, he takes over the lead singer. He falls down the ramp, blood going down.
Thank you. I appreciate that. That's very nice. I was trying to keep that low key. Anyway, since it's out there, no. The first show we did, I was so worried about getting, you know, as much practice time in up in my room in this like a casino. I can't remember the Viva, Indiana, really nice place. My first room, it was a big deal. And I called my wife and I'd been rooming with everybody else in all these other bands, having a roommate, you know, like a drummer or a bass player. But with Kenny, you know, I had my own room, and it was not only a room; it was like a suite.
Yeah.
With a separate shower and in a, you know, jacuzzi tub, and I call my wife and I'm showing her pictures, and she's awesome.
Yeah, the
Kimmels
never gave you that.
No, not at all. No, but anyway.
That's awesome. Yeah, we got to do shows with you guys in the UK. Some of those we were talking about that before the show.
Yeah.
Some of these hotels, because amazing. You're with Kenny Rogers, they're ridiculous.
5-star.
I mean,
it's awesome.
Unbelievable. I remember we had the TV that swirled around. It came out of the bed. And you know, we're just the opening act. How's this happening? But again,
that was a lot of fun.
I'm sure all the opening acts can attest to this. Got treated top drawer. I mean,
yeah.
It just
catering was awesome.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
He scared my kids. Kenny scared my kids to death. You had your kids with you on this show.
Yeah.
Peachtree,
yeah.
Georgia. And my kids were with me on the show, and your kids were with us.
Exactly.
We hung out at the pool and all that good stuff. But we went in, and my kids, the first time they've ever been to the Kenny Rogers show,
uh-huh.
And we're in catering, and we walk in, and Kenny walks in, makes an appearance, and he doesn't say anything, but the first thing he says was, hey, you kids, don't eat all the green beans. Scared my kids to death.
He was a big practical. He was a harsh kid.
Three yellow green beans. It was great.
That's awesome.
First thing he said. It was awesome. But Brian, you're amazing, and you did a great, great job with the band. I love watching you. Again, we were open for you guys. I love to watch your guitar work. You play a lot of different styles you can play, to me.
I fake a lot.
No, you don't.
Yes, I do.
Yeah, to me, what's your influences on? Like, is it strictly country? I hear some jazz. I hear other things in your guitar style.
A lot of Larry Carlton and Brent Mason, who plays a ton of styles. I mean, just studying him, you learn a lot. But
yeah,
there's tons of guys.
Larry Carlton,
Albert
one of my
Lee
favorite guitar players of all time, too.
Yeah,
got to see him live a few times. Incredible.
I saw him once. But
well, this is Brian Franklin, everybody.
Thank you,
everybody. I want to again plug again. Our Christmas album will be out real soon. It's Kenny Rogers Band featuring Don Gatlin, Christmas album, 10 classics, one brand new Christmas song on there. It's called Every Day's Christmas. And be looking for that. KennyRogersBand.com is the website. I want to, we have an amazing Jared. It's Jared James, this amazing, talented singer-songwriter who is a huge reason we get to do this show. Mm-hmm. His Pickin' and Grinnin' show he does all the time. He has his own podcast. All kind of things, his own radio show, and it's his birthday, everybody. Happy birthday to you. And folks, John's over here. We got John over here. Well, Matt's not with us tonight. He's okay, I hope. John's with us. John, it's not your birthday or anything strange, is it? But he's behind the scene. Have we gotten anybody watching the show tonight did request a song? I'm just curious. We don't have that up and running? Okay. Okay. Jared, if you can, you want to check that out? I'm just curious on that. That'd be pretty cool to see if somebody, you know, wanted to hear something particular. Album cut off side B of...
good luck.
That'd be tough. But folks, there was a song back in 2000 that I got to write. My first cut that I wrote for Kenny Rogers... as I mentioned before, it was very emotional for me. I literally cried on the way home when I first time I heard it, because I just couldn't believe it that he recorded one of my songs, that voice on a song of yours. I felt like no matter what happens after that, that I can consider myself a songwriter. Gene, you guys, and Randy, you guys write songs and everything, and it's like everyone in Nashville does. Like in the old, Mike, you know, the Longhorn and places like that, everyone used to go hang out. And it was like, there was a Longhorn restaurant there on Demumbrian. And everyone would hang out there, and they're all trying to make it. And like, every bartender, every waitress is a songwriter, singer-songwriter.
My landscaper's a songwriter.
Randy's landscaper's a songwriter. But and there's nothing wrong with that. This is the town to do it. This is Music City, USA. Try it
without a pedal, without a sustained pedal.
We'll do at least a little bit. That's all. Yeah, why not? Oh, okay. Here's a song that was kind of successful. Lady, I'm your knight in shining armor, and I love you. You have made me what I am. I am yours. My love, there's so many ways I want to say I love you. Let me hold you in my arms forevermore. You have gone, made me such a fool. I'm so lost in your love. And yes, oh yes, I always want you with me. Won't you believe in my song? For so many years I thought I'd never find you. You have come into my life and made me whole. Forever, let me wake to see you each and every morning. Let me hear you whisper softly in my ear. In my eyes, I see no one else but you. There's no other love, love like I love. And yes, oh yes, I always want you. For so long, lady, your love's the only love I need. And beside me is where I want you. Kenny Rogers Band, y'all. They're amazing. You guys did good. Yes. David Abdo back there filling in over there on the bass for Chuck. And that song is not an easy song just to fill in. Got a few chord changes there going on.
A few, couple.
What a great, I'm sorry. Hey, you're close to not getting to the after party, Waffle House after party too, buddy. You're that close. Hey, you know that song? So that song I actually sang and did back in the day. It was real popular to do the like the karaoke cassette tape. You'd go into one of those booths, and I went and did that song trying to win my wife over, who's still married to me to this point. Maybe when this airs, it won't. She won't be. No, I'm kidding. No.
So you play your
Kenny Bird. No, Randy. My wife. One thing we had in common. She was a big Kenny Rogers fan too. And I made a tape for her of singing the song, and that scored me major brownie
major points
at the time. Thank you very much. I still have that cassette somewhere. Yes, those karaoke tracks. They're amazing. Oh, what are we doing? Oh, that song I was telling you about. That song is a song called I Won't Forget. It's a song I wrote for Kenny Rogers. And Mr. Dwayne Eddy, a little side note, the legendary guitarist, Dwayne Eddy, Brian, played on the record. Yes, he did. How cool is that? I'm going to get a drink. For those non-musical people out there, this is called vamping. It might have been a Saturday night. It ain't clear it was so long ago. It was somewhere across the county line. A dance or a party, I don't know. But I do know you look like an angel. And your eyes were the color of your dress. There's a million things I don't remember. But that's the one thing that I won't forget. It might have been a Saturday night. It was either my folks' car or yours. I know that we went to some drive-in. But what was playing that night, I'm not sure. But I am sure you whispered you love me as my lips softly pressed against your neck. There's a million things I don't remember, but that's the one thing that I won't forget. Was 2:21 on a Sunday. I was just standing in the rain. You blew me a kiss through the window as your greyhound was pulling away. Inside I was dying to stop you. I should have listened to my heart. My head. There's a million things I don't remember, but that's the one thing that I won't forget. There's a million things I don't remember, but you're the one girl that I won't forget. The Kenny Rogers Band. Thank you very much. Folks, if you just joined us, this is the Don Ellis Gatlin Show. That's me. And my special guest, the Kenny Rogers Band. Awesome. Again, I want to point out we are missing two of the fellas, the incredible Mr. Chuck Jacobs on bass and the incredible Mr. Steve Glassmeyer on keyboards. Steve's such a great writer. Guys, you know more about this than I do. But I think he helped a lot out on the amazing Christmas show that y'all have toured. That's one of the highlights for Kenny Rogers fans for years. That show is fantastic. Can you know a little about the information about that?
He was the main lyricist. He and Kenny did all That's the lyrics incredible. For the for all the what the 10 songs on the show.
That's a great show.
And Warren Hartman, one of the other keyboard players at the time. We had three keyboard players at the time. He wrote the music. He and Steve wrote the music, but Steve was the main lyricist for the show.
Was Linda Davis, was she involved in that show too?
No, that was after.
That was after? Linda's such a great singer. I know, a big friend of you guys, and she's been such a big, great opening act and great. She does a great job singing on some of the Kenny Rogers records. I remember album around 91. She did a lot of the, including the hit single at the time, If You Want to Find Gold. If You Want to Find Gold, go looking in the mountain. That's a great song. Skip Ewing song. It's a Skip Ewing song, one of my favorite writers. But do we have any more requests out there? I'm putting these guys on the spot. We might not do the whole song, maybe just a little bit. Like our, we'll show them an example of our Kenny Rogers speed round. Is there anything out there, Jarrett? Okay. We're getting a request. I got one while we're waiting. I know you ain't got this. I think I broke the pedal last show playing piano, but I have a request. Can we do just a little bit of Morning Desire while we're waiting?
Without
to get
a sustain pedal.
This was a number one song. Gene knows this one. I don't know if anybody else knows this one.
It's really heavy.
I know. We'll just do maybe a little Gene and I. Gene and I do a little bit while we're waiting to get a song up. This was a number one song, 1985, written by Dave Loggins. Yeah, that sounds good, Randy. Here it is, 7 in the a.m. It's gonna take more than waking to rise me. I wake up with this need again. To feel the love of a woman beside me. Oh, it's just one of those days when I want to lay here with her and love her while she's still and listen to the rain fall along the roof.
Yeah.
And the thunder sounds like horses' hooves. Oh, I listen to her breathing, it makes me want to wake her up and tell her that I'm on fire. With morning desire. Tag it, Gene. With morning desire. That's one of my favorites.
Me too.
Oh, what a great song. Great song. Well, we're going to get to those. Through the years, we can do a little bit of that one. A little bit of that one. Speed round. It's just a little bit through the years. If you want to hear the whole song, Gene, before you kick that off, I'm sorry to interrupt you, Gene. Before I interrupt, I'm going to interrupt you for just real quick. I want to also throw another thing I'm very proud to be a part of. As tribute to Kenny, we did Through the Years on Zoom. Thing and that you can go on the KennyRogersBand.com, check out, or on YouTube, like the show on YouTube, check that out. Our tribute to Kenny. So proud to do that with you guys, all the guys. We did Through the Years, and check that out. We're gonna give it a little bit for you now. I can't remember when you were there. When I didn't care for anyone but you, I swear you've been through everything there is. Can't imagine anything I'll even miss. Can't imagine anything the two of us can't do. Through the years, you never let me down. You turned my life around. The sweetest days I found with you. Through the years, it's better every day.
like we made, and I'm so glad I stayed right here with you.
Awesome. Thank you so much out there. Appreciate it. If you want to tip the guys, we appreciate it. Folks, on the drums back here, the newest member. Yeah, come on up here, Mike. No, I changed my mind. Go back.
Hello, Vegas.
Mike's on, right?
How you doing tonight?
What's up, Mike? Hey, man. What's up, man? You know what? Were you the ones going to wear the shorts tonight?
No, that was Gene.
That was Gene. Okay, Gene.
Yeah.
Good choice. Good call, Gene. folks, this gentleman is obviously an awesome drummer. You had some big shoes to fill. The drummer before you played with the band quite a long time.
Yeah, Lynn Hammond.
Lynn.
If you're watching, Lynn, hey, buddy. He was 25 years? Yeah. He was
great. That's a long time.
Great player, yeah. Kenny's only had three drummers.
That's amazing.
Yeah, Bobby Daniel.
Bobby.
Yep.
Yes.
Yeah.
Don't forget Bobby. I can't forget Bobby. Bobby's a very unique gentleman.
Yeah. I feel honored to be just a small amount. He keeps his guys for a long time, as you can tell.
Yeah. How did it happen for you? How did this go down?
Well, I was playing at church with Clara Oman. Hey, Clara, if you're listening. And she was being produced by Billy Dean. Billy Dean, of course, really? Association with the band. And Randy came out to see Billy's new project, and that's where I met Randy. And then we just struck a friendship. We started recording and playing together. And then
for anybody that doesn't know Billy Dean, which a lot of people out there I know do, Billy had an absolutely great career in country music, hit after hit, had some gold albums. And but he's a part of the Kenny Rogers family.
Oh,
he's
yeah.
He sings the harmony with Alison Krauss on Buy Me a Rose. He's toured with you guys, open for you guys.
Yeah,
all that good stuff. So he goes.
Oh, yeah,
anybody that doesn't know, check out Billy Dean. Check out Billy Dean stuff. It's awesome.
Billy the Kid.
Yes. So you got in the band. What was the first show like?
I don't remember.
You have no memory.
No, all I know is what Kenny. And he's like, good job or something like that. And he actually called me out and he said, this is our new drummer. And I was like, oh, hello. So yeah, it was cool.
But I mean, like when you like to practice, get ready. But when you. And you've got great spirits. You work with other great acts, too, leading up to that, which yeah. always helps, I'm sure.
Sure, oh, yeah.
But when that first song, which was the first, do you remember the first song? What was the opening number, first song you played?
Love or Something Like It.
Love or Something Like It.
Blot and Blot.
Which Steve Glassmeyer is the co-writer with Kenny Rogers on that song.
Absolutely.
And absolutely. And the, so what was it like? I mean, that first down, but you know what I mean?
Well,
it's a difference.
You know.
The adrenaline's flowing.
I've played with Tracy Byrd and Earl Thomas Conley, and each time, no rehearsal, just a book and notes, and same with these guys, and just follow the thing. So my head's in the book the whole time, and once in a while I'll look out and I go, hey, there's Kenny Rogers. That's pretty cool. And and what's his name again? I can't remember. And so we play, and so, you know, nose in the book for at least a month, and then.
Well, we've kidded about this a couple of times tonight. But there is a situation on a big, big show. I think it was Today Show. Was it the morning show?
Today Show? It's Fox and Friends.
And it came to that magic moment to introduce the band. He had no trouble
it's
with anybody
YouTube, when,
until it came to you, Mike.
Yeah.
That was pretty funny.
It was funny. Well, yeah, I got a moment there on the TV. Well, actually, that was in the web version of the.
Yes, and they just kept giving you plugs after that.
Yeah, they were like, come on, Zimmerman, you know, and all this stuff. So, yeah, it was pretty cool.
But you mentioned two really, really great country music artists. Earl Thomas Conley, who we also lost recently.
Yes.
Like 17 number one songs. I don't think people realize all the big number one hits that he had, one after another. And then for the Keith Whitley fans, he did an amazing duet called Brotherly Love.
Yes.
With one of the best country records of all time. Mm-hmm. And any story there? I mean, like, it was...
I can't tell those.
Can't talk about it.
It's a family show, right?
It's a family... Yeah, you can do it. You can do it.
No, it was a fun bus. I mean, we had a good time.
And Tracy, I do know,